2016, Eddie Chambers, one of the best heavyweights in the world, is getting in the ring against Thomas Adamek in New Jersey. What do you say about that fight?
That's actually a heavyweight fight I would definitely look forward to. I am looking forward to it. It's a kind of a tough call. You know, Eddie's got the fast hands. They don't call him Fast Eddie
Chambers. Joe Goosen told me he's slick.
He's slick. He did manage to go the full distance with Klitschko.
Vladimir.
Vladimir until he got stopped. But, hey, he did what he could. And Vladimir's a big guy, man. But I think Adamek's style fits in very well with Eddie Chambers. Adamek's the first. He likes to brawl. He likes to mix it up. But he likes to box, too. And Eddie, you know, Eddie's got some tricks up his sleeve for heavyweight, you know, especially with those quick hands that he's got. I would probably give the edge to Eddie because he is younger and he is still fresher. He hasn't taken as much punishment as Adamek has. So I give the edge to Eddie Chambers.
And then let me ask you about another fight. They're talking about Gennady Golovkin against Dmitry Pirog, Russia against Russia. A lot of people are excited about that.
Pirog, you know, it's ever since the Jacobs win, it seems like he just hasn't looked like what we thought he should look like, you know.
And he hasn't fought really since then.
Yeah, well, he's fought a couple guys from what I understand, but just it wasn't like the kind of sensational performances that he had against Jacobs, you know. And Jacobs was a pretty good fighter, but Gennady Golovkin, oh geez, I've only heard things about him. I haven't seen him fight. But I would definitely have to say that, I don't know. That's a tough one to call, really. I'd have to watch Gennady Golovkin to definitely come up with a better prediction for that one, that's for sure. So,
Any takes on Pacquiao Bradley?
Pacquiao Bradley, that's 50-50 for me, definitely. You know, Pacquiao's got the hand speed, he's got the power. He seems focused with his newfound Bible studies and just being a more devout Christian, cleaning up his life. He doesn't have the drinkers and the smokers around him anymore. I noticed that on 24/7. I mean, good for him. You know, at least he doesn't have a bunch of leeches around him anymore. And Bradley's like Clubber Lang, man. That guy's just training like a man.
Rocky, you're going down.
Bradley's the one promoting this fight after what he was saying on 24/7. He was like, you want it? He's like, show me you're better than me. Show me you're better. When I saw that, I'm like, all right, this dude is coming to fight. And Bradley, hey, you know what? This could be the fight that we could see what Bradley is truly made of. I think if Bradley can handle Pacquiao's power, that Pacquiao's going to be in for a long night. But I still have a tough time picking the winner for that fight as well.
There you have it, Ryan Meza, all the way from the Outlaws Boxing Club in Tarzana. And right now he's walking the streets of Los Angeles, heading to the weigh-in of Latif Coyote, Antonio Tarver, Kid Chocolate, and Winky Wright. FaceNewsReporting.com. I'm Isaac Beck reporting.